Hello and welcome to today's episode of TSARP. I'm your host, Andrew Weir, and today our co-hosts are Sam and Steven.
Oh, hi guys.
Hello.
So today we got a bunch of exciting topics, starting off with the Summer Code Conquest. Who's excited for that?
I am.
I am too.
I think we all are. Our second topic today is that all the KidOYO Dark Mode live streams are now uploaded onto our podcast platforms. Wherever you're listening to the podcast right now, you can go watch them. And of course, they're also on YouTube, where we stream them live every Friday. So if you missed them or just want to watch them again, you can watch them on all of those places. And at the end of today's episode, we're going to be doing a new segment on some cool tech gadgets we found, all after our intro. Like I said, the Summer Code Conquest registration is over, so I hope you signed up if you wanted to sign up. They said they might do another one this year, but we really haven't heard much about that. It's going to be a really cool event. Sam, Steven, and I are already signed up. And yeah, I mean, I can't wait. I haven't actually done a lot of coding lately. I've been doing a lot of dark mode stuff. I've been playing games, but actually coding in Python, I haven't been doing so much of that. So I really got to get back into it for this hackathon. You know, Hatch isn't really my thing, so I hope there's a lot of Python. You know, Sam and Steven would definitely beat me if it's only Hatch. So I'm excited. The map does look, I mean, it is a Europe map, and there is the French flag. So if it is a Europe theme, what do you think the challenges might be, Sam and Steven?
Make a game where you have to make a sandwich with a croissant.
Wow.
Wow. Maybe they construct a double-decker bus or something?
That's an interesting one. They do have that sprite.
Like that.
Yeah, they do have that sprite in Hatch, right? The double-decker bus.
Yeah.
So I really can't wait. I mean, that might just be the cover, but I think it might be like a Europe theme, you know, with the French flag, a map of Europe. So I'm excited. And yeah, I don't know. I those are good guesses on the challenges. Last week, we talked about a new update on Scratch. It adds a new color mode to Scratch with higher contrast. It's a really cool update, and it has a lot of benefits, especially for people with color blindness, but also, you know, when you're coding and you want to put less strain on your eyes, the higher contrast mode definitely helps. So Sam, you've been using it a lot over the past, 2 weeks? So you want to kind of give us an update on what you think it does and how it's been helping you?
So I've been using it like so much, and it just helps put less strain on my eyes, especially late at night while coding. It just makes it really easy to code.
Yeah, it definitely is a cool feature. I hope it comes to Hatch pretty soon, because Hatch is, of course, the KidOYO version of Scratch, and I think it would definitely benefit a lot of people over there. But for the time being, if you guys want to take advantage of it, all you need to do is just go into Scratch, go into Settings, and the color modes are right there. So definitely a cool update, and thanks for giving us your opinion and how it's been helping you, Sam. Today we're ending off our episode with a new segment, a segment on cool tech gadgets that we've found. So today's tech gadget is the GAN I Carry. The GAN I Carry is a smart Rubik's Cube. You might be wondering, what makes a cube smart? Well, a smart cube is a cube that has sensors built into the core, so it knows when the cube is in all different positions, when it's not solved, when it's solved, and all different really cool things like that. What's cool about it is you don't even need to plug it in. It has a battery in it that lasts up to like 150 hours, and you can always replace the battery when it runs out. It's a really cool gadget, and even though, you know, I've been cubing a lot lately, Steven has been cubing longer than I have, so he's going to tell you all about it and what its really cool features are.
Well, first of all, you can get pre-made scrambles. Then there is the advantage of being able to time it without a timer. You can just straight up scramble it and then tell the app to time you, and you finish and it'll stop the time. It's more accurate.
Yeah, I've been using that a lot lately.
Yeah. I think, if I'm not wrong, what's funny is that this cube, the GAN 356 I Carry, is the exact one that I have, Except mine's not smart.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. If you guys want to buy a cube, you can go to thecubicle.com. They sell amazing cubes. They have great products. Steven and I always get our cubes there. They have a great selection of smart cubes and regular cubes. And if you want 5% off, you can use code TSARP. It works on any of their products. When we came up with this segment idea, we reached out to them, and they also really liked it. So they were awesome and created a code for all of you to use. It's really cool. So if you were thinking of getting a cube or this convinced you, you really want the GAN356 iCarry, you can use code TSARP for 5% off at checkout. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.